Well, welcome everyone to our travel chat. And I'm John Werner, the president of Mass Travel Network. We are a network of just under 1,000 travel advisors specializing in travel to all parts of the world. And today I have with me one of our travel advisors, Patty DeRue, who was recently in Mexico. And so we would like to chat about what the experience was like going to Mexico. Mexico recently opened up for travelers back on June 1st and opened in some various phases throughout the month of June, with different resorts opening at scattered times throughout the month and 1st of July. But things seem to be going very successfully there. Handling all the health and safety protocols and still allowing people to have a great time on their vacation. So what we're going to talk about this morning. So welcome, Patty.
Hi, John. Thanks for having me.
That's great. So your trip to Cancun was 3-4 weeks ago, was it?
I was invited by Playa Resorts the 28th of July for their VIP experience at the Hyatt Ziva in Cancun. There were about 40 agents for 3 nights, 4 days.
Oh, wonderful. And so when you started out your trip, what was the O'Hare like, flying out of O'Hare?
Flying out of O'Hare, I wouldn't say it was empty. Let's just say that. I was actually dropped off. There certainly weren't as many cars, doing the drop off. So that was easy. But the airport is not a ghost town by any stretch of the imagination. There were certainly plenty of people there. Not as many as one would see peak season at O'Hare. Sure. The first trip when I flew down there in July, I flew on American Airlines. I will say with less people, there's less customer service for the airline. There were certainly less TSA agents. So you still need the definite 2 hours, as you're supposed to arrive at the airport ahead of time to allow yourself enough time to check in, check your luggage, get through TSA, and then still get to the gate.
Okay.
Obviously flying to Cancun, our flight was full, so our gate area was full, but the gates on either side of us where they weren't going to a destination, I think one was Cincinnati, I think there were 3 people in that gate, so... Certainly the gate area depends on the destination you're going to as to how crowded it'll be.
Sure. Makes sense.
Mm-hmm. And, yes.
But so it doesn't sound like really any delays or hassles trying to get to your gate.
No, there was really no experience that was different. Certainly a lot of customer service agents out there helping, the hand sanitizer everywhere, the markers on the floor to remain 6 feet, social distancing, trying to spread out, waiting in the TSA line. But the process is still the same.
Okay. All right. Well, that sounds easy.
Yes.
And you already answered questions about what was like in the terminals and at the gates. On the flight itself, you mentioned the flight was full, but was that seem pretty normal to you other than the fact that face masks are mandatory?
Right. Everyone wearing a face mask in the airport, obviously. Again, I was on American Airlines. All of the staff was wearing them. They have the plastic guards at the check-in counter. Again, the markers on the floor in the gate area. American Airlines was still loading the plane by their group numbers, so they have not changed the loading of the plane process. When you get on the plane, the flight attendants are standing at the front of the plane. They hand you a little bag, small 4-ounce, I think, water bottle, a cookie, and then a hand sanitizer wipes in the bag.
Okay.
Everyone, right, takes the bag. I saw everybody wearing face masks. I mean, it was, no questions asked there. And everyone was bringing actually their own sanitizers, wiping down the tray tables, wiping down the back of the seats, wiping down their handrails, things of that. So loading of the plane, and the flight experience was the same. Mm-hmm. There was no food or beverage cart after that. What they gave you once you got on the plane was it. So I will certainly say with people, what I notice when you're not eating and drinking as much on a flight, there's very few people that get up to use the restroom. And whether that's because they don't want to use the public restroom on a plane or they're just not drinking. But for 3 hours, I don't think more than 2 people exited their seats. So there's very little commotion or walking around at all which is what I noticed the big difference with flying.
Okay. All right. Makes sense.
Yeah.
On arrival in Cancun, did American deplane the same as normal, nothing different there?
Same fashion. I mean, they certainly asked, you know, we would ask when we arrive at the gate that everyone doesn't stand up and stand in the aisles and please respect, you know, social distancing. Some did, some didn't. You know, I flew on United a week later, and United was far more strict in that they actually exited the plane by row. But American did not change their exit policy. So, right. You know, right. A few rows exited and the next people would get up and get their luggage and exit off. So,
right. So yeah, in Cancun, I have heard that, you know, things seem to be pretty normal in the airport. Again, face masks are required. Did they want space everyone out in as 6 feet apart, I guess, going through immigration and passport control?
Same exactly upon arrivals there. You'll see the same markers. I certainly saw cleaning service personnel all over the airport, wiping down the handrails on the escalators, bathrooms. They were standing there. Everyone, again, in Mexico was wearing masks, markers. At the time we flew in, the gentleman did tell us they are using Terminal 4 for all arrivals internationally. So there certainly were some crowds there, but we did not have a long wait in customs to get through customs and immigrations at all. Maybe 15 minutes from beginning to end process.
Right. Yeah, so that sounds pretty easy.
Yeah, it's pretty typical. As long as you have your paperwork filled out, I think that's the lag time, is people aren't filling out the immigration's paperwork on the plane properly. But other than that, if you have your paperwork filled out, we exited right through.
Okay, good. Yeah. So, and the transportation to the resort, were you by yourself, your group, was it a big van loaded, full, or what?
There were four of us that were traveling together. We did have a prearranged transfer, so when you exit the airport, just as normal, they're all standing out there with their signs. They greeted us, hand sanitized us as they greeted us, walked us to the van that was waiting. It was a group of four of us. They sprayed our luggage down before they put it in. We were all still wearing masks at this point, so through customs, immigration, outside, greeting our driver, and then still driving in the car, the four of us were still continuing to wear masks in the transportation. They did state that a lot of the shared transfers in Cancun have gone away and that they are really just doing private transfers. I don't know if that's all the tour operators across the board, but for our experience, yes. If you're traveling with someone, obviously you're sharing it, but they're not going to put you in a car with someone you don't know.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, that's good to hear.
Yes.
When you arrived at the resort and you were at the Hyatt Ziva, you said?
Correct.
What was your first impression when you stepped out of the vehicle and into the lobby of the resort?
The Hyatt Ziva is absolutely beautiful. It's an open-air lobby. But when you arrive there, the hotel staff, again, all wearing masks. Some wear masks with the face shield. Some are just wearing the face coverings. They are standing out front ready to take your temperature. They also have shoe sanitation, so as you step out of the car, you are stepping onto a little pad that is sanitizing the bottoms of your shoes, and then you step into a little pad that dries them off. They take your temperature, again, pull your luggage to the side, they are spraying your luggage there upon arrival, and then you are brought to the lobby for check-in.
Okay, so they're doing quite a bit in order to keep things healthy and sanitized and all that.
Exactly. Yes. Yeah. I mean,
so it sounds like the resort you felt was handling your first impression anyway was, you felt comfortable.
I felt very comfortable. I have to say, when I received the invitation to travel, I had some apprehension. I was a little nervous to say, you know, one, I think because I hadn't traveled in 7 months, and then talked to myself and realized this is what I do for a living. I need firsthand information. So once arriving through the airports in both O'Hare and Cancun and then arriving at the hotel after the check-in process, I was very relieved and thankful that I went and could experience and see firsthand everything that they're doing. From the staff wearing the protective gear, plastic shields at check-in, the steps they are taking all throughout the resort, from the room to the pool to the beach, the towels. I mean, they really at Playa have not missed a beat when it comes to the new safety protocols.
Okay, well, that's great to hear. So, you know, in the rooms, I've heard or read that some of the in-room amenities have changed, or maybe they're not there anymore. I mean, did you see anything different about that?
Not at this particular resort. Certainly, there is a seal on the door. So the doors are sealed, so you know it's been cleaned. When you enter, they still have the mini bar. So the mini bar was still stacked. They still had snacks in the room. They did have the remote control for the television was wrapped in plastic.
Okay.
But other than that, they still had a bathrobe in there. The main difference I noticed upon check-in was that we were asked, would you like housekeeping and would you like turndown service? And that was certainly something new. And I think, you know, with the pandemic, may stay and become the new norm. And the reason behind that is trying to limit how many people are being exposed to your room and your personal belongings. So if you certainly want daily housekeeping, they will have that. And if you want turndown service, they will have that. But it was nice to be able to say, those items for three nights really aren't necessary. And so I was comfortable knowing nobody else was going to be in the room while I was there.
Yeah, I've heard of hotels and resorts doing that. Around the pool, so when you were outdoors and at the beach or at the pool, what was the experience like around the pool area?
What's nice about Hyatt Ziva, which personally for me, I'm not a big fan of a large resort. If I was picking a resort, I like a small boutique property. But in this case, and I think moving forward again, for anybody who's nervous out there, the Hyatt Ziva is a large resort, which lends itself to the social distancing very well. There are so many pools, two different beaches, areas of space where you aren't sitting on top of people. So their beach towels are all wrapped in plastic. Again, it's a self-serve, so you don't have to have somebody touching the towels and bringing them over to you. So they're easily accessible, which was nice. But I didn't have anybody more than 6 feet. I don't think I had anybody within 20 feet of me around the pool area. So it was very nice. So for somebody that's looking to get away and still have all the amenities, but not worried, about too many people, a large resort is absolutely the answer because people can just spread out. They also have to keep the hotel at 30% occupancy.
Oh, okay. That's the rule there.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it didn't feel empty, but it certainly, people were not on top of you.
Okay. All right. So, and then we're still full service around the pool. I mean, you could get a drink, but I've heard that the swim-up bars at a lot of those resorts, and I don't know about the Hyatt Ziva, they have not opened the swim-up bars, have they?
The swim-up bars were open. We stayed at Hyatt Ziva. That swim-up bar was open. We also did site inspections at the Hyatt Zilara and the Hilton down in Playa del Carmen, and the swim-up bars were open at all three of their properties.
Oh, okay. All right. Mm-hmm.
So they still have, yes, poolside service for people walking around, and then you can swim over. People were not gathering at the swim-up bar, as I have seen in years past. You swam over there, you got a drink, and you swam back. They do have the protective glass at the swim-up bars as well.
Oh, they do? Okay.
Yes.
Great. Did you use the beach at that resort, or what was that like?
The beach, yes, we did swim in the ocean on both sides. The Hyatt Ziva has two beaches. One was their calm beach. That the beach chairs were open, cabanas were open, cabana service was there. There was absolutely no sargassum or seaweed, so the beaches were swimmable, walkable. It was fantastic.
Oh, okay, good. And so were all the bars and restaurants open, or do they scatter? Some are open certain days and nights and closed other times?
Certainly, yeah. I believe there's 7 restaurants there offhand, and they are opening 3 a night, so on a rotating basis.
Okay.
So not all, obviously, with 30% occupancy, they don't need to have all of them open. The buffet is open for breakfast and lunch. They have a theme night. I think I wanted to say two nights a week that the buffet was open for dinner. But other than that, it's the a la carte restaurants. The bars as well. The Cerveza bar is open every night of the week, but their other bars, they are rotating.
Okay, all right. So then how are they handling the buffets these days?
The buffet is open. It is no longer a self-serve buffet. So again, all of the food is behind the protective glass. The plates are behind the protective glass. So you simply walk up to the different buffet station, tell them what you'd like, they plate it for you, and they hand it around the protective glass. So still the same omelet station for breakfast and eggs and all of that, fruit station. They're still making smoothies and juices, and fresh fruit is cut up, but you are just not handling any of the serving of the food yourself.
Okay. All right. Well, I know at the Hyatt Ziva, one of the things that I've read, I've not been to the resort myself, but I know that they have a microbrewery there, and there's a tequila and mezcal bar and stuff. Did you have an opportunity to enjoy and relax in those places, and how were other guests reacting in there?
The microbrewery is the location that is open every night. They have live music there on certain nights. They had a DJ there. It's where everyone gathers. They have indoor and outdoor seating. I will certainly say, if you're nervous about crowds, that was probably the crowdiest, the most crowd location. People were in the bar wearing masks. Others were not. Guests, that is. So that was a personal preference. The other two bars, like I say, were rotating nights, and we did not, they weren't open the nights that we were there. So it was really the one location. I don't know if it's Hyatt Ziva or Mexico. I think it's Cancun itself has an 11 p.m. curfew. So the bar and everything does close down at 11 p.m. There is no more serving of drinks or cocktails. So everyone kind of scatters at that point and heads back to their room. All of the entertainment ends at 11.
Okay, but the hotel has room service too, so you can
correct.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And like I say, you still had your mini bar, so if you needed to go back for a nightcap in your room, you still had the mini bars, and they still had room service going.
Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But the gathering areas at 11 o'clock, they closed down.
Okay. Well, what was your favorite restaurant at the hotel?
Oh, Habaneros, without a doubt. Okay. It's on the beach, beachfront Mexican. Best fish tacos in Margarita, and the setting there with the turquoise water is fantastic. So
I was going to ask you what was your favorite dish. It sounds like
if I'm going to Mexico, it's fish tacos.
Yes. I like those too. So did you have an opportunity to use the Zen Spa there? What was the spa like?
The spa was open, but it was a working trip, as we like to say. So we were out touring hotels during the days that we were there. So no, we did not use the spa. The one day I was at the pool, the spa attendants were walking around and doing the complimentary massages as they do at the pool and beach area. So it is full service. It is open, but I did not experience it firsthand.
Okay. All right. So I know, the staff at the resort, they're required to wear masks. But as far as the other guests, I mean, you said it was really a preference of whether other people wore masks or not.
I would say there was a handful, not even half of those that were there. Like I say, from the beginning, you wear your mask all the way through to check in. And at that point, when we received a welcome cocktail in the lobby at check-in, we took it off. Mm-hmm. I did not wear my mask again on property for the remainder of the stay. When I left property to ride in transportation or tour the other hotels, I did. There were guests that would wear their masks, like I say, walking to the breakfast buffet. Then they'd get their meal, obviously take their mask off. There were maybe a handful that I would see wearing their masks around the pool area. But that was all. Out of the 30% occupancy, a handful of people on property would have a mask on.
Okay. So besides some of the other hotels in the area that you visited, were there any other times that you went off property? And if so, where did you go?
I did not go off property. Some of the other travel agents I was with had actually gone and walked into town, very quiet in downtown Cancun itself. The shops were open, but not a lot of activity going on down there with bars and restaurants and shopping. So very few people actually walking the streets and leaving the resort. Okay. Most, I think, that are coming or staying on property and are enjoying, you know, what the hotel has to offer.
Right. Yeah, makes sense. Tell me about what you would say was your most Instagrammable moment on the trip.
Oh, Instagrammable moment. If you're in Cancun and there's no sargassum, it's certainly the turquoise blue water. It was just, yeah, fantastic. I can't tell how many pictures I took of the water, the pool, the people, you know, enjoying. So the trip overall was fantastic, relaxing, answered a lot of questions, took a lot of, you know, the unknown out of it for me. The pictures speak for themselves all over my Instagram and Facebook page.
Well, it sounds like the views from Habanero, that restaurant you set out by the waterfront, it's also a great photo.
Yes, that is their only outdoor dining, beachfront dining, and that is my preference, again, if I'm down there and can eat outdoors. The other restaurants are all air-conditioned indoor properties, which are wonderful in and of itself, but to be outside and, yeah, see the ocean and hear the waves, that's the best location.
Yeah, oh, it sounds fantastic.
Yeah.
So when you returned home, you said you were, I think, gone 3 nights, but mm-hmm. So what was the experience like coming home?
Returning back through Cancun, everything there again is the same process as before. Check-in, everyone's wearing masks. The airport is certainly, again, like O'Hare, a little more crowded because they're using the centralized terminal. All of the shops, all of the restaurants, everything is open in the Cancun airport. Same markers as you found at O'Hare for social distancing. They do have every other seat blocked off so that people aren't sitting next to each other in the waiting area. There is the health questionnaire form that you have to fill out when you depart out of Mexico coming home. It is most easiest to do on a QR code. So you do the QR code beforehand, have it on your phone. They were asking for us to show it to them before we went upstairs through TSA. I will again say their TSA was a little bit slower, so not as many lanes open, so it did take us a little bit longer to get through. But same process departing, you know, Cancun. Then arriving into O'Hare, very few flights, as we know, are traveling international, so the international airport is very, very quiet. Once we departed the plane, I'm going to say it was 15 minutes total from when we got off the plane to when I was able to get back in my car and leave the airport.
Wow, that's unheard of.
Unheard of for O'Hare. Absolutely no lines in the international customs area at all.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Which is sad to see, but it is nice when you want to get through quickly and get home.
Sure. Well, it just sounds like a really great experience for 3 days, and allows you to really see what's going on. So when you talk to customers, clients, and so forth, it's gives you the ability to share your knowledge and, of course, reassure them that they can, if they want to travel, they can do it in a good, safe way. So
safely, without a doubt. It was a wonderful, like I say, relaxing trip, learning trip. Exceeded my expectations, gave me some peace of mind, was so wonderful that literally came home a week later, grabbed two of my agents, and we went back to Cancun so I could show them firsthand what it was like. And that's all, you know, that's what we're in the business, to have the firsthand information so that I can share it and we can tell people and talk very confidently as to what it's like.
Right. Good. Well, do you have any other trips coming up then?
Unfortunately, no. But we're always, we will take any invitation that we can get to get back down there and see how things are going.
Yeah, well, as other places start opening, reopening, and I think opportunities for all of us and everything will become more available. So
I have one of my agents leaving this Sunday to head down to the Dominican Republic. So we'll have some firsthand knowledge from that location as well.
Yeah. Well, that's great.
Yes.
Well, any other final thoughts that you want to share about your overall experience?
You know, I want people to know that they don't need to go it alone, that there is a lot of misleading information out there. There's a lot of confusing information. It was an unknown time for all of us. And so, you know, to use a travel agent, reach out to your travel advisor, support your local business, and let us help you find the right destination, the safe destination, and help you get there.
Yeah, good. The good advice. Really appreciate it. So, thank you, Patty. I appreciate your time and your experience that you've shared with us and everything. And it looks Mexico and Cancun in particular is definitely very inviting.
Thank you for having me. Appreciate it.
Take care.
All right. Bye-bye.